Hi everyone. This video we are going to discuss about RPA tool selections. Previously we have one video for tool selection, but it has no audio, only without audio, only video. I had added one small slider, but today we can discuss about some briefly how we can select the tool before moving to project. So when we talk about tools, now RPA has Automation Anywhere, Blue Prism, uipath, workfusion, Mega Robotics, OpenSpan. So we have many of the tools available in market. So now in market, uipath is blooming and it's equalized to Blue Prism now. So now uipath has the first position because the uipath has the separate Citrix automation per BBO automations. uipath have some different logics and some new Citrix related components. So if you go for automation which is related to BPO, then probably we can move with uipath. That is the first preference. And if you want to add more code stages like .NET related string variables or manipulations, whatever you want, in uipath we can easily move into code and easily write the code and add the DLLs. And uipath has web orchestrator related control room, so everything has been looking good in uipath. If you want to go with Citrix automation as well as BPO automation, the second thing is, see, when we go for Automation Anywhere. So Automation Anywhere is simply you don't need to write any code, simply drag and drop, and simply you can write the logic. That's all from Automation Anywhere. Without knowing any programming languages, we can easily go and check Automation Anywhere. So when we talk about AA and uipath has free up community. So if you want to write any concerns or any ideas, they immediately accept and they will plan to implement on it. But AA is not like that. AA has not much documentations, but uipath has much more documentations. Even Blue Prism as well, more documentations, but AA has no documentations. So simply they have created a tool, but if you want to ask some questions, if you have to raise ticket into Automation Anywhere support tool and they will respond later, so that kind of situations. But here in uipath there is lot of community blacks and you can easily involve and you can get in touch with or resolve your queries. And if you talk about Citrix, that AA has not much Citrix related things, but in workfusion RPA Express and workfusion both have different Citrix environment. So if you want to select Citrix, that is probably workfusion as well as uipath I will recommend on it. But workfusion is a new tool and still most of the MNCs are going to do some R&D related stuffs in workfusion, and workfusion has integrated with artificial intelligence, so they had come up with new solutions. That is the different thing. So the next thing is why we go with uipath. See, actually when you talk about attended and unattended automations, if you go attended automation, any tool is good. Automation Anywhere, Blue Prism, uipath, workfusion, everything is good because it is attended. But most of the processes are going with, not most, 99.9% will go with unattended, because unattended has much more good and best practice for the RPA environments. So when you talk about unattended, so Automation Anywhere has some issues and we have to resolve it manually, and Blue Prism we have very less, and uipath also very less. Workfusion, that is unattended mode, we have some cognitive computings. So and OCR related stuffs, the workfusion environment and workfusion tool has added some more features. Optical character recognition related features are added in workfusion. When we talk about script, AI has script based everything. AI, you can drag and drop script, no need to write any script, but it will accept and it will add a component of VBScript and it will JavaScript, and you can add on it in your within AI. And one more thing, within AI you can add metabot DLLs. In Blue Prism, that is another thing, you can add whatever your code into the code stages. But in uipath, whatever you want to write, you can add into .NET code in uipath code stage. So that is one thing. If you want to, in workfusion as well, the same. They have some .NET code stage features, and you can, if you want to add, then system.xml or whatever the namespace, you can add and you can do it your application. So this is the one. And if we talk about communities, AI has no open community and everything would be licensed. BP has no free community, everything has been licensed, and license cost as well very high. But comparing to uipath, uipath has license cost is very low. And if you want to add 5 licenses in uipath, that would be equalized to 2 licenses of Blue Prism and 3 licenses of AI. So that much of variations you have. And workfusion, they given only 1 license free for single bot. For multi-bots, you have to add and you have to get the license based on the price. So that is another case. So when we talk about client based servers, the client based servers and control room based servers, everything would be based on the tool selection. So that will not affect our tool selection methodology. See, when we talk about another thing is uipath has front and back of his robots, so they have easily manage their robots with the back of his tools. So the process has been easily managed. Other things are all are the same with three tools. So when you talk about tool selection, the main thing you have to check on it, easy and deployment related things. See, when we talk about deployment, the AA instead of AA, BP has some more reliability. Because Blue Prism has release files, you can move only the release files into the deployment and it will be freeze the code and everything, it would be good to move the code deployment. But AA has separate control room and you can move into control room into scheduling and that kind of, you have to add some stuff. But comparing to AA, Blue Prism has some more reliable on deployment. But in talk about uipath, the same BP and uipath deployments are very easy and reliable. And when we talk about next step, testing, the testing part is Blue Prism has very easy to test process and object design oriented, and uipath as well easy to test and move into code. And when we talk about uipath, they have supported multi-part with very low up cost. So these are the features involved in tool selection. So when we talk about next one is OpenSpan and Becker Robotics, they are also given easy community, but the thing is still they are in research and development. Now we have AA, BP, uipath and workfusion that are all still in market and we can easily use and move on it. So when we go with other tools, Selenium, they are related to testing tools. In Automation Anywhere, we have one more tool is available, Automation Anywhere Testing. That is only for testing, but most of the people, they didn't use for Automation Anywhere Testing. They simply use AA tool for both development and testing purposes. Okay guys, thanks. We will see and learn more things in next video.